Hello everybody and welcome to the next episode of this Sharing is Caring tour. We are now leaving Istanbul and we are going to explore the rest of Turkey.
And you can see the amazing Turkey because it was so beautiful. We went to Ankara to educate our kids about Atatürk and the history of Turkey. After that we went to the biggest salt lakes of the world or Europe.
Yeah, one of the biggest salt lakes,
One of the biggest beautiful. Of the world. And then we drove away there and we saw a red lake, like red water. It's like we ran into some problems over there, but you will see it in the video, of course. And then we went to Cappadocia, and Cappadocia blew my mind, our mind, I can say. It was so beautiful, the air balloons and the nature. We did hiking between the mountains over there. Yeah, you will see, it's really cool.
Really beautiful. And we will also answer some of your questions in this episode. And then we will also
show you that we are now using Lite IM Bitcoin wallet, so that we send and receive Bitcoins using Telegram and Facebook Messenger. And the most beautiful part is that we are earning now Bitcoins because we refer Lite IM to other people like family and friends. You could do the same. I think we need to keep it short. So enjoy this episode. And if you have any questions, ask them afterwards in the comments so we can answer them in the next video.
Yeah.
Like the video, share the video, hit the bell so that you will be notified for the next video.
Enjoy.
Bye.
So because we don't go to school, Dad and Mom make us go to stupid things like museums or stuff like that. So now we're going to the, how is it called?
It's called Atatürk Mausoleum or Anit Kabar or something like this.
So we're going to visit that and yeah, that's it.
Who is Atatürk?
That's a good question, Jessa. Atatürk was the leader of the war of independence of Turkey. So he is like the founder of the Republic of Turkey. He was the first president of the Republic of Turkey. So it's a very important guy for the Turkish people because he fought the war to become an independent country.
So if mom and dad say it's 10 minutes walk, then is it 30 minutes walking?
Yep.
For the Turkish people watching the video, do you pronounce it as dur or dur? No cats.
Can we take this cat?
Where?
To home.
In our van?
Yeah.
Nah.
That's a beautiful cat, isn't she nice?
Did you like the Atatürk Mausoleum?
Yes, it was hot, but it was really beautiful.
Beautiful. Did you learn anything?
Yeah.
Okay, so who's Atatürk?
He is the man that made it possible that Turkey is still Turkey and not Greece and Russia and all those countries.
Oh, that's enough. You'll discover more when you Google about him. What is it that I can help you with?
Yeah, we want to send some of our bitcoins to our nephew in Indonesia, but how are we going to do that?
Do you mean Silvio from the Moluccan Islands?
Yeah.
Okay. Man, are you honest? Do you want to share your bitcoins with him?
Yeah.
High five. This is amazing. My kids want to share the bitcoins. What I would do at the moment, I would use, the most easy part would be probably, do they use Facebook?
Yeah.
Or
Telegram?
Yeah, then use Facebook or Telegram. You use Lite IM
It's a bot on Facebook or Telegram, and you can send, receive, and exchange Bitcoins, Litecoins, and Ethereum. It's very easy, so you can explain them in a very simple way. You send your sharing link to Silvio. He will receive the link. He can install the wallet on his Facebook Messenger or on the Telegram, and then you can send Bitcoins to him, and he can receive them.
Okay.
Cool?
Yeah.
Perfect.
Now driving from Ankara to Cappadocia, and on our way to Cappadocia there is a salt lake. It's called Tus, something like that, Lake Tus, and it's one of the biggest lakes from Turkey, and it's a salt lake. So don't know what I'm going to see. It must be really beautiful, so I'm excited to go there. On the lake. Did you ever walk on a lake?
Never.
Never?
The first time.
First time in my life I see a red lake. We are driving to this red lake. White lake, red lake. Turkey has it all. Let's bring the Bitmobile into the sea. Visited the Salt Lake, Tuk Lake or something here from Istanbul to Cappadocia. Now we found a lake. It is red. It's like a red lake. This, I never felt something like this. You see, it's getting red over here. The water is red. I think this is one of the strangest things I have ever experienced. I already walked on white salt lakes like I did before today. I have never seen a red lake like this, and I have never walked in water on salt, and it's really red. The sea is red, the water is red. Did you ever experience something like this, woman?
No, my first time.
Is this your first time?
Yeah.
So the boat lost our virginity.
You
in,
have all
in the red sea.
What? Salt in your, on your face.
So I'm on camera with my salty face. Yeah, I spill water, you wash.
Next question?
Yeah, next one.
Okay. When was the first time you knew about Bitcoin and why you decided to follow it?
The first time I knew, got to know about Bitcoin is around 2013. It's a very long story, but I will keep it short. In 2013, I still had a big business and I still had this dream of becoming millionaire. And then there was a guy who told me, Didi, have you ever heard about Bitcoins? And I was like, no, tell me. And he started to tell me it's going to disrupt the monetary system. It's going to be the new money for of the future and you can become a millionaire out of it. And that was, of course, my first sign in my head, millionaire, because you know at that point in life I still wanted to become a millionaire. So I started to investigate, and then afterwards I invested some money into building mining rigs, and I started to mine Bitcoins, and this guy helped me with it, and that's how we started with Bitcoins. Okay, yeah, so the primary reason at that time in my life was because I thought I could get filthy rich of it, and I could got to disrupt the monetary system, and I love to disrupt some things that are not totally honest. So that was the first time.
Well, we just parked the car. Going to visit the village, walk up the castle up there.
There, That's high. Up there. That's really high. That's where we're going. Need to wait for the kids and the wife. Can you believe people living in these houses? How beautiful. Stairs. I'm kaput, let you say. It's high, and we need to be in time for the sunset. And we, of course, were too late. Like always, I'm too late. Good morning. We had a beautiful day yesterday in Cappadocia. We went to the castle up on the hill. This morning, we are going to do a hike. It's a short one. It's, I think, 2-hour hike. We are going to hike through White Valley and Love Valley. Don't know why they are named like that, but we'll see. And should be beautiful. People advise us to go there. So let's see how beautiful it is. I think Romain is going. I'm going. Jessa is doubting of going. Juna and Julie, they don't want to join us this morning. They are still tired from last night. So let's see who goes.
Are they good?
What?
Taste one, Jess.
Taste. You can taste. Where do we need to walk? To the road?
They told us we need to go to the road, but I found a shortcut and hopefully it's doable for us. So we need to walk here.
So you think it's a safe shortcut?
Of course.
Our man found a shortcut on one of the apps we use. The app is called maps.me, I think, because you can use it without Wi-Fi. And I hope the shortcuts are really shortcuts. That's the cool thing of hiking. You never know where you go. So scream. Bitcoin! Blocked my way now. Hey, they are going to walk us. So we found again new friends. Dogs keep tracking us all over the trip. You know why? Maybe it's a sign. So beautiful. We are in the central of Anatolia. I think it's near Cappadocia. The hike is amazing. I've never seen something like this. Oh my God, she was the toughest one. She's now a little princess. Please become daddy's toughest one again. I think we're almost there.
18 minutes.
18?
Yeah.
No, I can see the top over there.
18 minutes.
Are you tired?
No.
Okay. Fresh orange juice. Can we pay with Bitcoin? No Bitcoin?
Okay.
Do you need what Bitcoin is? Pour this with fresh orange juice. That really tastes good after a hike.
Better. Woo! Nah. Yeah.
After a short break, now really almost at the end, we can see the camping. Can you see the camping, Jess?
Yeah, I can see it very well.
Ooh, good, good, good. Good morning. Today the balloons decided to go the other side. So we were I was a little bit late. They were around 5:30.
But now you are floating like over the Bitmobile. So it's very beautiful.
Almost ready to go.
Goodbye, Cappadocia.
I have seen many speed limits, but check this one in Turkey. You can drive 82 kilometers an hour. 82. Why? Please, somebody explain to me why 82 and not 80.
So we are now driving to Saldagulu. And it's a lake.
A very beautiful lake.
A very beautiful lake. With special water or something.
I think there are two lakes in the world with this kind of water. I don't know why it's special, but there are only two lakes in the world with this kind of water.
So that's where we're heading to right now.
How long did we drive?
We drove like for 7 hours.
Yeah.
Really long.
Very long.
Well, that drove 7 hours.
We arrived at Lake Golu. It's Turkish holiday and you can see this. It is packed. It is full of people camping in nature. It's free camping. It doesn't cost anything. Yeah, that's free there. Free as always, but not anything. And there is a lot of food. You can eat at the Turkish families and everything, but the kids want to go to a restaurant. Juna wants to go to a restaurant. So we need to search for a restaurant.
Saldagulu. Turkish holiday. Busy times. Waiting for the day guests to go and we can park the car like in front of the lake.